Pre-seasons, do they get any easier?
No.
Do they get harder?
Get worse. And Brian McDermott started off really intense as well. They wanted to start well. And a lot of people have asked me today about 2015 when we had some big names leave and some of the difficulties that contributed to the year after the 16, and obviously with Magsy and Rob leaving last year. You know, we've got a lot to contend with in filling them holes. But we've got a great new group of players, both youth, and Richie Myler and Brad Dwyer have come into the group. Been fantastic, Nathaniel, and they're really going to contribute. We're gelling really well, and it's a real privilege. You know, I've done a lot of seasons, a lot of pre-seasons, and each one you think, wow, this is hard, and you just want it to end because it's tough, but you know that it puts you in good stead for the season. And we've been refined, we've been built up, and looking forward to the start.
Looking forward to it. It's a big start as well. You've got to go to Australia as part of your commitments, but what a privilege that is, and what an achievement it'd be if you can go there and win.
Oh wow, wouldn't it? It was 10 years, I think, almost a week when we played them, that we played them at Elland Road back in 2008. Got the win there, and we've played them a couple of times since, and never been a million miles off. It's a new challenge going to Australia, obviously, but how good were England? You know, who'd have thought 6-0, and you know, maybe not for the fact that Callum had studs on that too long, the ankle tap, you know, we might have got a win there as well. So we'll prepare as best we can, and we'll go over there. We'll go in there with the intention of winning, without a doubt. But it's a big, big challenge, isn't it? And whatever happens, it'll put us in good stead for week after and rest of the year.
You've played in all the big games, you've won all the big trophies. What's it like for you? Because this is a new challenge, isn't it? Go to their back garden to play them.
Yeah, life's, I keep banging on this idea, life's a narrative, and we all love telling stories. That's why we stood here right now, and I just want to go hear a new story. You know, I listened to some of the old history of the Vikings. That's the only reason why they went to battle, so they could go home and tell stories on the table. And we're not going to go to battle in the same way they did, but certainly fighting for this Rhino shirt, that's what we're going to go do. And it'd be a great story to tell. They've got some aging players as well in their team who are sort of coming to the back end of their year, but world class as well. So it'd be a big tough ask, but we're going to go do our best.
You talk about stories, same old one, everyone wants to beat Leeds. Yeah. They're going to have to go some to do it though, aren't they?
Mate, they've always wanted to knock our heads off, which is great, and I'd be disappointed if they didn't. That's because we've been doing well, and I share that with the utmost humility as well. We got the grand final win last year, and teams are going to want to knock us off and beat us, so we're going to have to be good, but that only helps us to improve. It means we've got to be good and switched on every week, and we've got a bunch of young, fresh boys who've not experienced what I've experienced, so you know, it's new to them, and they'll want to go into war every year, every week.
You talk about the 2015 and what happened after that, and it seems the club is in a better place because there's guys like you around and there's guys that have experienced that. How much of a help is that going to be?
It's going to be a big help. Experience is a big thing. You know, it goes a long way. And again, it's just telling them stories and having that insight, I think, into what's gone on before and how you dealt with it. And we've still got Rob Burrow knocking about upstairs, making a lot of noise somewhere. And all the other guys are really close to the club, even though they're not actively involved. And Brian's working as hard as he ever has done. You know, he's obsessed with it almost sometimes. And we're getting all the preparation we need on the pitch. So just looking forward to getting our first few games under our belt. But you never really know until you've had them.
Can I ask you about the captaincy? It's obviously Callum's got that. Was that something you wanted to do, or do you accept that?
I've always said I'm more of a prophet than a priest, and some people might puzzle by that, but you know, I'm probably a little bit abstract and a bit left field and do things a very different way to others and think differently as well. And if I've got something to say, I'll say it in any way. You know, this is my club. It ain't my club. I wish it were. I wish I owned it. But I feel like it's my club, and I feel like I'm part furniture. I want the best for it. So, of course, we're all going to contribute. But Callum's a world-class player. He's got experience of going over to a place like Australia and competing against the Aussies, against the best players. And not only that, I think Callum, Brad Singleton and Stevie Ward have matured into some fantastic professional players on and off the pitch. And Callum in particular steps right up. He's been fantastic this last two or three weeks. And you know, it's a real honour to be under him and serve under him. You know, we'll look back in years to come and at the group of boys that I've been fortunate to play with, and they're standing up back of my neck now, and some of the captains I've had, including Kev and Franny Cummins and those types of players. Yestin Harris, was he captain? I'm sure he was at some point. Callum Watkins is just another one, fantastic player and a great choice.
Can I ask you about Brian McDermott? You mentioned him earlier. What is it about him as a coach that makes him so great?
I think he's a realist. He's played the game and he gets it. And I think sometimes sport can get too textbook, too scientific, and life isn't really like that. Science does help and it gives us a bit of an insight and an idea, but in my experience, anecdotal evidence takes you that a little bit further. Just that experience and that desire and the intention to roll your sleeves up and say, let's have it, let's go do it. And I think once you've got that camaraderie and team spirit and trust, mate, trust is number one word within the group, then there's not much you can't achieve, regardless of whether 1 and 1 equals 2. You just roll your sleeves up and go do it, get it done. You know, that branded Nike advert, just do it. It's as simple as that. Don't have to be all clever and high tech. Just get yourself on pitch and go smash somebody. And you know, Brian's got a little bit of that mentality, but he's smart as well. You know, he listens to his coaches. He'll tell you himself. He's got a great staff. The club's really well facilitated. We've got great facilities, so we use what we've got to the best of our abilities.
You're going to be on the road a little bit this year. You've got to go to Elland Road a couple of times. What's that going to be like?
Yeah, Elland Road's not really on the road. It's Leeds, isn't it? All Leeds, aren't we? I love it, mate. And I was a big Leeds fan as a kid. So when I've played there, for international and for Leeds as well, it's been a real privilege. We paraded the trophy about a week after we won it there. Had loads of support from Leeds United fans. It's all about the city, it's about Leeds, you know. It's not necessarily into sport, but we just want to go there and put our best foot forward. And to me, I'm still playing in Leeds, so it'll be good.